Well, welcome back. And it is a busy, busy time for us. And we wanted you to know about GLOW, which is the Lyric Theater, GLOW Lyric Theater, here in the upstate of South Carolina. And they're celebrating four seasons. You're really going into five seasons. And Christian Elzer is here. He is the general director, and he makes everybody do the right thing.
Yeah, that's exactly what I do. Thank you. I'm thrilled to be back.
And Diana Thompson is here, and Diana is a beautiful soprano. Beautiful. And we're going to hear some music in a minute, but I said originally this was light opera. Now,
originally
all of a sudden, you're playing tricks on us because you're going to do La Boheme.
La Boheme, which is grand opera.
It's as grand as you'll ever get.
Indeed it is. And it's a wonderful, wonderful opera. It's one of my personal favorites. It's perhaps one of the most popular operas done in this country and overseas, and therefore I think is accessible in a certain way. There are tunes that people know from this opera that they don't know they know, even
That's
if they've
right.
never seen an opera in their lives. And in fact, the tune that Deanna's going to sing here in a moment is one of them.
Oh yeah, and it is. It's a great love story, and you're doing it in its original Italian.
In Italiano, but fear not, there are English super titles projected above the stage, so you won't miss a word.
This is some of the most beautiful music ever written. And it's one melody after another.
One after the other.
And it's just, I admire you for taking this. A big undertaking.
It's a big show. There's no doubt about it. We have the fantastic cast of main characters. We have a full chorus. We have the full children's chorus in Act Two. At one time, I think there are almost 50 people on that stage.
And you have an orchestra.
We have a full orchestra.
Which you're going to conduct.
Which I'm going to conduct. We've had our orchestra rehearsals. They sound great. I could not be more excited. I could not be more excited. It's going to be fantastic.
And why did you decide? I'm curious. Because you've done some wonderful things in the past, and all of a sudden...
There it is. You know, we started life as Greenville Light Opera Works, a light opera company, which I still love. We did Fledermaus, which Deanna was in, actually. We did some Gilbert and Sullivan, which is wonderful. But, you know, I've spent my career as an opera singer. And I thought, you know, I really, really want to do some grand opera. And we thought we would broaden our reach. It's not that we won't do comic opera.
Yeah.
We still do some.
Yeah. You can do
it all. But we wanted to do it all, honestly. And we changed the name to GLOW Lyric Theater to better reflect that it's not just light opera, comic opera. It's full grand opera as well.
Now, most of your cast comes from... part of the country?
Well, I think our leads, this year it shook out that most of them are from New York. You're from North Carolina, and I think there's one local of the leads. The chorus are all local, and the orchestra are all local professionals.
Yeah.
So it's a great mix.
Yeah.
It's a great mix.
Well, we have a treat because, and I want to talk with her afterwards, Diana Thompson has agreed to sing for us, and she's going to sing an aria that is much loved throughout the world, Musetta's Waltz Song from La Boheme by Puccini.
Oh,
Bravo. That was beautiful.
Thank you.
And you make your home in North Carolina.
Yes.
But we'll claim
yes.
you. We'll claim you. And that was just lovely.
Thank you.
Diana.
Thank you.
Yeah. And you teach as well, don't
yes,
you?
Yes. Yes. I have a private studio in Burlington.
Okay.
Yes.
So you managed to make your way over here to do Lava
yes,
Land.
Yes.
And this performance begins at the Gunther Theater in downtown Greenville. Mm-hmm. When is the first?
Opens July 31st, Thursday night.
That's right, yeah. And then August 3rd,
mm-hmm.
which is a matinee,
yeah.
and August 7th and August 9th.
Which
so you've got four
matinee.
Performances.
Yeah, we have four performances, which will be great. The Gunther Theater is a wonderful, you've been in it. It's
yes,
a wonderful
yes.
hall. It's about 500 seats,
yeah.
so it's not too big.
Yeah.
You'll be able to see and hear everything that's happening.
Yeah, and you have a way of presenting all kinds of opera, light opera, musical
mm-hmm.
things for people. And many people out there will say, well, you know, I don't know anything about music, and I've never been to an opera.
Right.
Well, this is your chance. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Opera is theater. And I think if you think of it that way first, there's a beautiful story being told, you know, of love and
yeah.
Don't let the classical music nature or the fact that even that it's in Italian intimidate you. You're going to be surprised. You're going to be so engaged in what is happening on that stage and this beautiful music that you will honestly forget you're at a quote-unquote opera. You know, even
and
if
we don't have much opera as such in this part of the country,
not
unfortunately.
So much. You know, Glow Lyric Theater is currently the only professional opera company in the state of South Carolina.
I didn't know that.
You
started this, didn't you?
I did.
You got into a lot of trouble.
Me and my wife, Janet Tamasia Elser. Yes, we did. Because I moved here and saw that there were no professional vocal arts. I mean, Bob Jones does a wonderful opera every year, but that's in an educational setting. And there's the Spoleto Festival.
Well, they do a brilliant job. But it's once a year.
Once a year. And we produced two shows during the summer. And then two, during the year at the Yount Center down in Fountain Inn, we're doing a Mall in the Night Visitors in December. And
always thought about at Christmas.
Christmas time. It's a great Christmas time opera. And then we'll do another smaller opera in the spring. Not sure what it's going to be this year. We did a small version of Carmen, actually. So something like that. So we're bringing opera back.
And you can buy tickets through the Peace Center. We have a phone number, which is the Peace Center box office.
Yes.
And do you have any special prices for students or senior citizens?
The ticket prices are $35 for everyone. There are some special $45 tickets if you're feeling,
okay.
if we want to sit up close. And we have student prices at $25. You just have to have a valid student
yeah.
ID at the box
yeah.
office.
And then there is another number, which is their particular, if you want more information about the Glow Lyric Theater or what they are doing, or perhaps you'd like to get involved.
Absolutely.
That's the number to call.
Now,
do you use volunteers?
We do. You know, we couldn't survive if it weren't for some wonderful volunteers that we have that do everything from ushering to some PR work. Folks that even do a little bit of backstage work. We have some production assistants that are volunteers this season.
Okay, now, Diana, tell me about yourself. I know you teach. Where have you sung? Your voice is gorgeous.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. I've sung in New Hampshire, in New York, Mississippi, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina. So mostly on the East Coast.
Mm-hmm. And did you start out saying, I want to be an opera singer?
No, actually. My idols were Whitney Houston and Mariah Carey growing up. But then after being in chorus, I went to a fine art high school in Georgia, in Augusta, Georgia. After being in chorus and taking private lessons, I found where I was supposed to be. So.
And you teach. How important do you feel it is for young people to be exposed to the arts? Not just opera, but the whole...
Very important. I always tell my students, you can't learn to love something that you don't know about. So exposure is everything. The community in which I teach is a very big musical theater town. So I get a lot of really talented students, and they're very hardworking. But to expose them to mm-hmm. opera is really important. So we actually just watched our first opera at Opera Night at my house. We watched Bohème. So.
And what age group?
Mostly high school students. I have a couple of college students and okay. one adult student right now, but mostly high school.
And what is their reaction?
They love it. They love, they're very intrigued by how we use our bodies mm-hmm. to magnify the sound without external amplification. They just absolutely love it. And of course, they look for technical things.
Now, will you use mics at the Gunther?
We will not. Okay. It is an opera. So it is a full orchestra and no mics. So don't worry. You'll hear everything.
And you yourself mm-hmm. are a singer.
I am. I'm baritone.
I would never have guessed it.
Yes. Who knew?
Yeah.
Who knew?
Yeah. So what did you do before? I mean, as a singer?
Oh, sure. I've sung with Lyric Opera Chicago, Chicago Opera Theater, Lyric Opera Kansas City, New Orleans. I've done a good amount, and then I became a crusty old college professor.
Oh.
Yeah. And started teaching.
Where?
I teach at Presbyterian College.
That's what I thought. Give them a plug for heaven's sakes.
I know. I bad me. Presbyterian College. Very fine music program.
Opera as such has never been something American. I mean, it's not an American art form that most people
absolutely
recognize.
The funny thing is, there are wonderful American opera composers. Okay. Carlisle Floyd is from South Carolina.
That's right.
Leonard Bernstein, Aaron Copland. I mean, all wrote operas. But no, we don't always think of it as a distinctly an American form. But Americans, certainly in the early part of the 20th century, really took up that mantle, and there's still great American opera being written. Mm-hmm. Jake Hagee and Ricky Ian Gordon, Philip Glass, wonderful stuff out there. Mm-hmm.
So you plan to keep on doing something exciting like this?
We're going to keep on keeping
on. How many people in this cast? You mentioned there'll be a lot of people on the stage.
If you count the chorus, I think we are at around 45 or 50.
And there are children.
There are
in
15
as well.
Kids in it.
Adorable.
They are wonderful. And we had a little opera camp this summer, speaking of education.
Oh.
And the kids went to opera camp, and then they also learned their parts for the chorus, and mm-hmm. we integrated them right into rehearsals.
And they have a good time.
They have a great time. They love it. And ages 5 to 18. Mm-hmm.
Now, if you'd like any more information, because, you know, summer's over now, and you think, well, it's time for school, but you will keep on with these programs.
Absolutely. We'll do opera camp next summer. Absolutely. A Mall and the Night Visitors, which we do in December,
that's
certainly family friendly.
That is something, the mm-hmm. whole family, because
it's charming.
Christmas.
And A Mall is sung by child, and will be.
Yeah. So you're always busy.
Always busy.
Yeah.
Well, life's too short not to be busy.
Absolutely.
And Diana? When you do this, what are your plans then after these performances?
Wow. Well, I return home and teach for the fall, and then we have the Great Migration around November, December for auditions. And then I'm actually doing a Susanna.
The Marriage of Figaro,
yes,
Mozart.
tell
people what it is.
Yes. And I'm doing, I am doing Donna Clara in Zemlinsky's The Dwarf.
Okay. So you're also very busy.
Yes.
So this is 4 seasons under your belt, and you're reaching into the 5th season.
We will be reaching into the 5th, yes.
And it's Glow Lyric Theater.
It is.
And many of your performances will be at the Gunther Theater.
Every summer we're at the Gunther Theater.
Which is downtown mm-hmm. Greenville,
Peace
if
Center.
You've never been, mm-hmm. at the Peace Center. And it's if you're from out of the area and you've never... Make this an opportunity.
Absolutely.
To hear some glorious music, and I'm sure it's going to be a beautiful production.
It is looking to be a fantastic production, on a par with anything you'd ever see anywhere else in this country.
And people will be coming from New York to do some of the leads.
Absolutely, yep. New York, a couple from Greenville, a couple from North Carolina, so yeah. All from all over.
And costumes and sets and an orchestra.
Costumes, beautiful set.
And a beautiful romantic love story of La Boheme.
Beautiful story.
Which
bring
really
your hankies.
Means the Bohemians.
yes, the Bohemians.
The Bohemians.
Yes, bring your tissue.
Yes,
it's a little hankies. Sad in yes. a beautiful way.
Yes.
But the music never yeah. ever goes away.
No.
It haunts you.
Yeah.
Thank you both so much. Thank you for
Thank
coming.
You for
Good
having
luck to you, Diana.
Thank you.
Beautiful voice.
Thank
beautiful
you.
Job.
Thank you.
And remember to put that, if you've never been, this is your chance to do something special. And if you have a young person in your life, take them along. Let them see. Another world. We'll be with you next time. Stay happy, and we'll see you then.